again, wenn ich ganz anders skill selbst, dann kann ich das sehen mich. Again, skill set, fortunately, your parents want you to do something which normally you get it. And in the day, you find somewhere where you never even thought about. So even the same thing applies when you are going to think about some of the job opportunities that are in education. See, like when you are going for an education, like UK or US, most of the time your communication skills comes in picture. Like anything like a GRE, CAE, SAT, anything you go for it, more than 80% of the average is given for your English language. So I'm not sure how many people really concentrate on English language when you are in education. Why I said that your graduation is a choice or chance? Because you people take it like, I have to do a graduation, so you complete a graduation, which is going to be just for a degree, which doesn't help you. You are looking for any after education or an opportunity. So when you come for again the job opportunities after, this is the same issue here. The first question, like, you know, the after job opportunities are divided into basically five sectors normally you get in. I don't know really how many people are really interested in going abroad from this particular law. But again, it is like the first sector and the most preferred sector is again US, then it comes UK, then Australia, Southeast Asia, Pacific, then it is Middle East. A normal graduation with a post graduation, or yet 2 years of any higher level diploma or any other qualifications along with your graduation, which works out to be sometime around 17 years of educational qualification, which only gives you that eligibility to enter into the US market. Next to that, it becomes your skill sets. The US market is so competitive and they look for a very high level of skill sets. And it is more on the IT sector. So, they get here, anything short of the skill sets, it becomes difficult for you to enter into US market. When it is taken on UK, it's almost similar except for your 16 years of educational qualification doesn't come in picture as well as the UK, Australia, and Middle East and Southeast Asia Pacific normally takes any graduates or any undergraduates is fine for them as well as they are happy with their skill sets. When you talk about the skill sets, it can be anything. Any, as far as the skill sets is concerned, most of the times it becomes it can be anything, right from typewriting to software skills, anything like any of the software skills can be any of the come up in there in the organization itself. Potentials are so huge, but normally you don't get any of the required skill sets of employees for this particular industry. Today, the telecom industry is one of the topmost priority where you have the highest attrition rate. And if you take the telecom industry is a very, very young industry where it is only 6 to 7 years old. But in this 7 years, if you talk about any of can see them heartless working in three of the major telecom companies. Sharpness, that shows you what is the employment potential in this particular industry. Normally, any of the industry doesn't prefer immediately a succession from the same domain or from its competitors immediately. But the telecom industry is one which, because of the non-availability of the skill sets, they go to this extent of recruiting between their own competition people. And the same way, if you are talking about offshore recruitments and offshore your own opportunities offshore, until and unless it becomes too difficult for you because you are not in city, it becomes too difficult for you to develop your own communication skills where you can get into any of the offshore markets. So the only way what you can do it is shed on all your whatsoever it is. It's better to practice talking to in English within your friend circle, which should definitely improve your spoken English skill, which is one of the major things which people expect when you are going to go or when you are expecting an offshore position. Except for Middle East, all the four regions which I was saying you expects you to be good in English. Definitely you came to US, expects you to be very good in English. Again, when you have skill sets and communication skills, definitely getting a job in offshore market is not going to be a very big issue for you, except for your taking a qualification comes in picture, where today some of the European markets needs you to be a postgraduate when they are looking for your opportunities in UK or US. You are supposed to be 18 or 16 years, that's either a professional graduate like BTech, or is the next option for him is like you can do your basic computers or something where you can go for your post graduation of your MCA or MSc computer science. But definitely the market is changing way, not like earlier way, an MA postgraduate was even offered a job in US. Today, at least the postgraduation, they are looking for a particular and a specific skill set what you are going to apply for. So, if you have any plans of going offshore or abroad, any of these countries, except for Southeast Asia, Pacific, which covers here, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Philippines, and the other countries, and Middle East, it's better you can concentrate on exactly what you have to do right from now, where you will have at least a couple of years of time from now, where you can definitely think about how to improve your communication skills. And improving your communication skills, as Mr. Srinivasan was saying, it's not a very great deal where normally people get carried away. For example, like as he was saying, you are reading a newspaper, seeing some of the English channels or English news channels like CNN or BBC, and above all these things, if you people can talk to your friends, most of the times when you are in your college, especially if you can, if you are not able to talk in English with your friends, out of the college, at least inside the college, if you start practicing talking in English, definitely down the line within a couple of years, you can become a better spoken English, which is going to be one of the most wanted criteria when you are looking for any opportunity abroad. And again, in the Middle East, you can look for jobs other than
IT, you have got job opportunities in the construction industries and the other things. So you can look for some of the options of that. And as far as if anyone is interested in afterwards and the other things, I have just given my email ID to your coordinator where you can get in touch with me at any time. You can mail me for any of your clarifications. Anyway, I thank KDF and Nagarjuna College for